Yes, I am.
Sure.
A lot of the lyrics I thought were just thrown in. I mean, they could have deeper meaning. I tried to really analyze them. But some of these lyrics just seem like, I think if I was stoned when I listened to it, maybe it was just, that's just like, I think they want controversy with that song, because all it is, some real meaning to it, I thought, other than it was just really blatant and loud.
Everybody's got an asshole and everybody's got an opinion. Look at that pillar. Fuzzy.
3 out of 8 people we approached said they never heard of Nirvana. What do you think of that?
They must be living in a cave.
They don't read music.
They have forsaken the age of information. They are to be eliminated.
Who responded to the song Rape Me said they were offended by it in some way, or that they couldn't understand it. Could you explain the meaning of the songs to perhaps clear up?
I think they...
Well, we're the cover boys of about 10 different magazines this month. Every one of those magazines, we explain it pretty good. It's a anti, let me repeat that, anti-rape song. I got tired of people thinking, trying to put too much meaning into my lyrics, you know, as being too, not making enough sense, you know, so I decided to be really blunt and bold. So, and I just thought it's kind of a funny just reward for a person who rapes, like a guy, like a mean asshole who rapes a woman, violates her, and then he goes into jail and gets raped, you know? Yeah. I think it's kind of a justice, in a way. I thought we've made our stance on rape clear within the last year and a half, you know?
Yeah, but
most anyone who knows about us would probably know that we are pretty much anti-rape
right
at this point, you know?
Why is that? If it's just this straightforward anti-rape song, why are they having a problem with it?
Maybe you shouldn't be talking about it. It's like taboo, you know? Daddy's bonking the little stepchild. I mean, we don't talk about that here. No.
What's controversial about an anti-rape song, basically? I mean, I guess it's the way, it's the nature of
it's a taboo, you know?
Taboo subject.
Yeah. The college charts.
Oh yeah, weren't we on the college charts?
College evolved into alternative.
It started with college, didn't it? What do we know?
We never went to college.
We never went to college.
What's college like? Is there girls and frat boy parties? It's pretty scary.
We played at a lot of college parties.
I know. We practically went to the Evergreen State College. I mean,
I know,
we lived there.
Went there every weekend. And no one studied, that's for sure.
Chris was booted out of here about a year ago.
Oh, yeah. You're banned from life here.
Yeah.
You got in trouble at the Sonic Youth Show, didn't you?
Chris's face is on a Polaroid picture in the office. Banned for life.
You blew my cover.
I'm just teaching her how to cuss and flip people off.
She's almost got it. She's just got to put all the other fingers down.
Well, it's a bit wet.
His nipples are really sore.
Her eyes are really open.
It's wonderful. It's great.
Hey, myself. Hurt yourself. Want some help. Myself.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dave Grohl, do a drum solo. This is our encore now.
Around me, your familiar face.
Kurt, you sang Seasons in the Sun?
Kurt rubbed his pee-pee on
the
camera.
Did I sing? Yes, I did. I don't know the words.
What's the best lyric in there in that song?
It's such an emotional song.
Who's like the best lyric?
Goodbye, Papa, it's hard to die.
But the stars on the beach were... I forget how it goes.
But the stars on the beach were just... No, the starfish on the beach were the stars out of reach or something like that.
Wow.
So long, silly boy.
You're lucky.
I just felt like I was a fucking hockey player on a big screen with a Budweiser sign above it. I don't know, it was funny.
do, and I was like,
well, see, what I was trying to do, but you guys didn't have enough ESP. I was trying to get up, when I was standing on top of the PA speakers on those columns, I was trying to do a solo, like, you know, arena rock solo.
It was the Led Zeppelin solo.
Yeah. Did you notice it?
Yeah.
Heartbreaker. Oh, I picked up on that.
I don't know how to play it, but.
I picked up on that in Sao Paulo, and I started doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. It was like totally awesome.
What can you do when you're in that kind of situation, you know? I thought I'd one last time test the audience to see if I could jump into it, and I failed. It's not working. It just, you know, and I stood there for a long time, and I know they couldn't read my mind, but I was trying to, like, with my eyes, trying to tell them, don't hurt me. Can't you tell? I mean, haven't you read enough bitching from us for the last year that we're not rock stars, you know? We're not trying to be, although we did display a lot of rock star things today.
Kurt, so when you fell, because you didn't really jump that hard. You just sort of, like, laid down into them. I mean, what happened to you?
They immediately just started grabbing for me, trying to rip my flesh off for souvenirs, you know? Oh, I have a piece of Kurt's forearm. Frame it. I don't know. It used to be so much fun in clubs, reminiscing about the old days. But, you know, I used to be able to jump out in the audience, and then the audience would, like, carry me all the way to the back. I'd, like roll around all the way to the back, and it was really fun. And it was like a celebration. Like, everyone's jumping, you know, throwing
like
up in the air and
ball.
Everything. Yeah. Like a beach ball at an arena rock concert. But these kids just, some of them just don't understand that. They're not used to that. So it's all they know how to do is to tear people apart. So.
And now for all your lawn care needs, it's Nirvana!
Chris, you have it.
Oh. Just read it.
Hello. Stay tuned for more Nirvana on ABC in concert.
I am Chris.
Hello, I am Kurt.
And I'm Dave.
And we are Nirvana, the band you see on TV too much. Change the channel.
What, as children, or like as a kid, what inspired you to get involved in music? What drew you to it? What made you want to do it?
I was inspired by the Monkees.
I don't know who I was inspired by. I think I was first inspired to play music by,
Speak and Spell.
No, punk rock bands, I guess.
Any favorites?
Favorite punk rock bands? Of ever?
I like all that punk rock. Billy Idol, the Cars.
Just ain't got no beat, man.
Duran Duran.
Duran.
Kurt, what about you?
Well, I think the only thing that I was inspired by was the Chipmunk Sing the Beatles album.
Nirvana.
Sounds nice.
Had a ring to it. We had the image and we had the name. All we needed were the songs.
Did you have a problem with a band called Nirvana from the Valley?
Yes,
no
we
comment.
Did. $50,000 problem.
Those jerk offs soaked us for $50,000.
Typical Valley, man.
Yeah.
You just wait till we get hold of that shampoo company, too.
Or the condom company.
Or the teen spirit deodorant.
Or the deodorant llama.
Yeah, I know.
And the whole Buddhist religion. We're going to sue the pants off.
Sue everybody.
Well, those are like Mr. Negatives. It's just like, isn't it a sunny day? Well, it's probably going to rain. Or my cat will get run over or something. There always has to be pessimistic and negative. We're positive, and no matter what the situation is, we always give it a bright outlook. Butterflies and fields and
rainbows and unicorns.
And unicorns and rainbows. Because that's what life's all about. When you sniff glue.
Who's somebody you admire? Who do you admire now? Okay, go ahead.
Zippy the Pinhead.
Zippy the Pinhead.
Yeah. He's cool.
I admire Evel Knievel.
I don't really admire anybody that much. Except for my immediate family.
That's neat, dude.
Oh, my Jesus, this is ABC.
Hi, Mom.
I've been so successful in the completely corporate garbage rock flooded music industry.
No way. We knew.
Yeah.
From moment one.
The magic eight ball told us.
That's right. We shook it up. We said, are we going to make it? And we looked at it.
Better tell you later. Then we shook it again.
Try again later. Yeah, and we busted it and drank all that blue stuff inside of it. Got really wasted.
It said drink me.
So we took the little cue one.
It's Vicks 44.
And then we shit it out and then look at it. Oh. And when we shit it out, it said try again later.
Hi, welcome to Bathrooms Today. Today I'm sitting on a beautiful porcelain can.
American Standard
with matching bathtub. Notice the lovely brown and white striped decor in today's most modern, appealing type.
Could you get up for a moment and dispose of this? You can throw it in the bath.
Well, you know, one time when a band I was in for Nirvana played in Spain, I had a fever, and upstairs of the club, right after we got done playing, I went up and I drew this really hot bath, and it was so steaming hot, and I had such a high fever that I took this bath, and then I got out of the bath, and I had welts on my forehead. I was so hot. And that was it. I teeter a radio right there, right on the edge, and I put like 2 ounce weights here and 1 ounce weight there, and I sort of make it so every bath is an experience in itself, life or death.
Living on the edge of the bathtub.
Kind of like having all this electrical equipment in a bath.
Oh. Are these the socks you got on the airplane?
Yeah, I've been wearing them ever since.
You want to wipe with this?
No, not my sock. I mean, if this isn't therapy, what is? He's sitting on a toilet in front of national TV. Christ, this is therapy. Okay, let me tell you. I've never taken a bath in front of 10,000 people.
We were the chosen rejects. We chose not to be part of the popular crowd. I mean, I can remember a lot of times the more popular people, the jock type of people who were into sports and staying clean and brushing their teeth all the time and doing what their parents were, you know, asking them to do. They always asked me if I wanted to join their little clubs, and I decided not to. You know, I would rather hang out with the people who didn't get picked for the baseball team, you know, and who smoked cigarettes and listened to rock and roll music. You know?
Skip class, you know.
Why did you go to school anyway at the first time?
Because you have to, for lunch.
Yeah, the hot lunch.
Yeah, it was just kind of a little scene, and just saw all the people who just kind of didn't fit in and liked punk rock music kind of congregated, and we just have our parties, and we wore like thrift store clothes, and we're just in our own thing, and that's when we discovered punk rock. And I know that's when I discovered that there was like nothing wrong with me. It was a majority of the people in town, there was something wrong with them. They were like really closed-minded, and I just could not get along with them. You know, they were just so rigid in their perspective. They just had just totally closed minds. It was stuffy.
So all three of you.
No, but actually, oh, look at that. People are swimming here with their clothes on.
Their clothes on. Idiots.
Maybe that's the most important thing then with the whole Nirvana thing, as it is called, that you actually give people the chance to find other bands, you know, finding those record shops and stuff.
Oh, it's a load of shit.
We'll be right back.
But I've always felt that, like, every 10 years, there's always a handful of really, really good bands. You know, there always has been. If I would have grown up in the 60s, the late 60s, I would have only liked a handful of bands. I think most of it's bullshit, you know, like Strawberry Alarm Clock and Vanilla Fudge and all that stuff. It's just crap, you know? But most of that stuff is looked upon now as being really cool, you know? But I only would have liked Blue Cheer and the Stooges, you know? And Black Sabbath. I can only think of like maybe five bands I would have liked if I would have.
Talk about you for a while. Is it fun to be famous?
Not if you're walking down the street.
Not when people recognize you. Not when you can't have a moment. You can't. The people are waiting in the lobby of your hotel and constantly asking you for your signature. Whatever. The hotel trashing, drug doing.
Just cliche.
Yeah, and it's just stupid. I mean, hey, we're a rock band. It's all Everett True's
fault. You know? It's all Everett True's fault. You know who he is? Yeah. He's the biggest rock star journalist there is in the whole world right now. Yeah. It's all his fault. He lies about us all the time. He's a dick. I hate his guts. He's a good friend of ours. He's fine.
It's constantly.
Well, journalists lie about us. Why can't we lie
about
us?
Yeah, right.
Right now, I'm standing here with two members of Nirvana, Dave and Chris. How you doing, guys?
Mighty fine. You look great, Tabitha. I have to dip you now.
Oh, your wife's gonna...
My wife's gonna kill me.
Excuse us. I see. And have you seen anything besides that has caught your interest?
Food tent.
Probably nothing I'm allowed to tell. Whatever. Yeah.
A lot of.
Were you approached? Were you asked to be part of that movie at all? No.
Anything. You know what I mean?
Oh no, they did ask us.
Really? Yeah, they asked John.
Said no.
I said no before even asking you guys.
Oh.
That's because I'm the leader of the band.
You blew my chance, man. I'm going to roll into Hollywood. I'm going to have a star on Hollywood Boulevard. And I'm going to have a big house with a swimming pool and all these cars. And I'm going to get divorces and stuff. What did you get by smashing guitars on the scene?
Satisfaction. Climax.
Well then, I think I'll just
pull up the pillow and go to sleep.
Good night.
Good night.
Now the thing's going... yeah, thing's going real quick, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean...
Okay, you both have had this conversation about exposure and pressure and...
No, I'm sick. I'm sick.
Well, you caught the English flu or something.
Touch me, I'm sick.
You can fry a head and an egg on that forehead.
You can fry a head on that egg.
That's right.
You ain't got a forehead, you got an eight head.
Magic eight ball head. We'll just turn it up and down. That's how we plan our destiny, was with that magic eight ball. You know, you turn it around, it says... Try again.
Comes out and says, yes.
Yes.
Yes. No.
No.
Why is this any more...
That's a Ming Voss to me.
I know. This could be... I mean, Elizabeth Taylor should wear that on her finger. I mean, what's the difference? Instead of reactionaryism, nationalism. So that stuff's like...
Involved in the music industry too. Make sure that it doesn't get as stale and as bad as it has within the last 10 years. Especially in the Reagan era.
Yeah.
Did I roll that too tight?
Sorry.
Looks like it. I think I did.
Yeah.
No, because
it's,
I mean,
too
you
tight.
Know, in the Vatican. I mean, they survey all these people and say, like, what do you like? What do you want to see? And they've been fed garbage, so that's all they know. And they say, we want more garbage. So they give them the garbage. They survey them again, and it's all this garbage. Next thing you know, you have this over full landfill full of diapers and styrofoam. And that's mainstream culture, is a soiled Pamper diaper in a Big Mac container.
You're talking of Hollywood, for example. You know, like, because it costs so much money to make a movie, and it's a risk, like, you're talking about commercial risk. What are they doing now? They've been doing for quite a few...
Doing a cover of a Christopher Cross song. Yikes.
And so we decided to start a band, and initially the band was just a Creedence Clearwater cover band to play in bars and hopefully make enough money to where we could buy some art supplies. People caught on, these rednecks in our hometown started taking off their big 10-gallon hats and going, "Woohoo, you guys are great." And all of a sudden we decided, well, maybe we can make some more money at this. To heck with art.
And do you share this lack of engagement yourself?
What, being apathetic?
Yeah.
Sure.
Why?
Why? Because we sleep too much. Punk rock should mean freedom, liking and accepting anything that you like, playing whatever you want, as sloppy as you want, as long as it's good and it has passion.
How would you define the music of Nirvana?
Twist of lemon.
It's like really patriarchal over there. Like the man is the king and society's broken down. So the women are being taken advantage of. And if we implement this center, women will have a place to turn to and they'll learn that they can speak out. They'll learn that there's a different way to live. And they'll be coming out for years. So they'll always have a place to turn to for, you know, there'll be women who'll be carrying this baggage around for 15, 20 years, and finally, maybe it'll break them, or finally they'll just learn, like, you know, I've got to deal with this, and they'll have a place to turn to.
Now, I was out there talking to some of the crowds, and not everybody is aware of what the cause is. Most of here like to check out the bands. Other than taking their money for this cause, raising the money for this cause, are you going to try to make the audience out here aware? Are you going to say anything, or what are you going to try to do to make these kids out there aware? Or is it enough just to the fact that they bought a ticket?
Well, usually when you attempt to make some kind of statement in a big place like this, people don't really understand what you're saying. That's why most rock bands have resorted to saying, "How you people doing out there? All right, party!" You know, so I really don't see any point in... I mean, the attempt is, it's a good idea, but I don't think it's going to be very effective.
Hi, I'm Charles Barkley, host of the season premiere of Saturday Night Live with Nirvana. Look, Mom, your favorite, Nirvana.
Jesus Christ, look at that camera.
Hi, I'm Charles Barkley, host of the season premiere of Saturday Night Live with Nirvana. Look, Mom, your favorite, Nirvana. I'm Charles Barkley. I'm hosting the season premiere of Saturday Night Live with Nirvana. I'm not a role model, and these guys really aren't role models.
Welcome back to the Headbangers Ball, Ricky Rackman here. Now, I don't know that much about how the industry charts and stuff like that work, but as far as street buzz goes, I can tell you honestly, I've never heard of a band getting a bigger buzz quicker than this band, and I'm not saying it seriously because they're here. I'd like to welcome Chris and Kurt of the band Nirvana.
Hi, Ricky.
So how's it going? I mean, it's got to be, first of all, love the suit.
Thanks a lot.
Be very comfortable on planes, I think.
On planes, yeah. Well, it's a bar. Fire. Headbanger's ball, so I thought I'd wear a gown.
Dress for the ball. There you go.
He wouldn't wear his tux. He didn't give me a corsage either.
Core of personality and ego is like humans are social creatures. So,
I can't hear.
Cover the thing that's covering your ears.
Oh, it's good to look at you. Yeah.
What and who is Nirvana?
Nirvana's three guys from Puget Sound. Area, Olympia, Bainbridge Island, and Tacoma. Nirvana is a seven-letter word, and Nirvana is a concept.
How would you describe your music and what you do?
We play a very powerful, high-energy type of rock and roll. We move around on stage a lot and just scream with an abandon, I guess.
How did you first get involved with this Sub Pop label?
By some luck, our guardian angel pointed us in the direction of Reciprocal Studios and Jack and Dino, who knows Jonathan Poneman. And Jack and Dino turned Jonathan Poneman on to our tape, and he thought it was really groovy. And he gave us a call, and we made a single, and then we made a record. And now this, we're here today.
What advice would you give to someone who's just starting out or wants to have a musical career?
Just keep practicing and don't give up. Just never give up. Play as often as you can and be really dedicated and try to write good music and don't worry about the material ethics that go with music. It doesn't matter what you look like or anything. It doesn't matter what your product looks like. It's what it sounds like.
Christmas, everybody.
And you too, RuPaul.
We love RuPaul.
Hello, I'm Dave.
Oh, I'm Chris.
And I'm Kurt.
And we're Nirvana.
And you're watching Raw Power.
We had fun, we had seasons in the sun.
I don't know that.
So here we have your typical American hard rock band setting up for a day's practice.
Blew my ears out.
Hey, by the way.
Hey.
Hey.
This goes into your guitar.
Hey.
I'm Chris.
And I'm Dave.
And I'm Kurt.
And we are... Nirvana!